أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، أرسله بالحق بين يدي الساعة بشيرًا ونذيرًا، وداعيًا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجًا منيرًا. فمن يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى، ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل وغوى، ولا يضر إلا نفسه ولن يضر الله شيئا. أما بعد، فإن أحسن الكلام كلام الله، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. سبحانك اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع، ومن نفس لا تشبع، ومن قلب لا يخشع، ومن دعاء لا يسمع. نعوذ بك اللهم من هؤلاء الأربع. My dear brothers and my dear sisters, our deen, alhamdulillah, it is the most perfect way of living. It is the most comprehensive deen on this earth. Allah Dhul Jalali says, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. The only way of life acceptable in the sight of Allah Dhul Jalal is Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Whoever it is that seeks any way of life other than Islam, then Allah Dhul Jalal will never accept this from him. And in the hereafter, he will be among the losers. This deen, deen al-Islam, is the only deen acceptable by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hence why, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah Dhul Jalali says, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. Today, I have perfected for you your religion, and I have perfected my favor upon you, and I am satisfied and pleased with you, Islam, as your religion. And our deen, what is its objective? What is the objective of our deen? As Sayyidina Amir bin Ribli radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, when he approached the king of, when he approached Rustum, and when he said, ما جاء بكم, what has brought you here to this land of ours? He said, we came لنخرج العباد من عبادة العباد إلى عبادة رب العباد ومن ضيق الدنيا إلى سعتها وَمِنْ جَوْرِ الْأَدْيَانِ إِلَىٰ عَلِّ الْإِسْلَامِ. We have come to remove the servants from the worshipping of other servants to worshipping the Lord of all servants. لِنُخْرِجَ الْعِبَادَ مِنْ عِبَادَةِ الْعِبَادِ إِلَىٰ عِبَادَةِ رَبِّ الْعِبَادِ. وَمِنْ ضِيقِ الدُّنْيَا, to remove people from the tightness, the restrictedness of this world. إِلَىٰ سَعَتِهَا, to its expansiveness. وَمِنْ جَوْرِ الْأَدْيَانِ, and from the oppressive nature of other religions. إِلَىٰ عَدْلِ الْإِسْلَامِ, to the fairness, to the justice of Islam. This is the purpose of our deen, to remove people from worshipping other slaves to worshipping the Lord of all slaves, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. As Allah Dhul Jalali said, that we have not created jinnkind or mankind except with the sole purpose to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And our deen is the most jami', the most comprehensive of all religions. Our deen is not only a deen of salah, of siyam, rather our deen is comprehensive, inclusive of all of our life. As Imam Abdul Karim bin Malik rahimahullah ta'ala, who is from Sibar al-Tabi'een, who he learned from the likes of Imam Sa'id bin Musayyib rahimahullah ta'ala, Sa'id bin Jubayr, Mujahid bin Jabal rahmahullah ta'ala. He says, فَأَدْرَكْنَا السَّلَفَ الصَّالِحِ وَهُمْ لَا يَرَوْنَ الْعِبَادَةَ فِي الصَّوْمِ وَلَا فِي الصَّلَاةِ وَلَكِنْ فِي الْكَفِّ عَنْ أَعْرَاضِ النَّاسِ. He says that we found our aslaf, we found our predecessors, we found them and they did not see deen. They did not see the best form of religion to be only restricted in prayer and in zakah and in siyam. But rather they saw the perfectness of their deen fil kaffi an aradil nas, in withholding from hurting the integrity and the arad, the honor of people. This is how inclusive our deen is, that to refrain from attacking the honor and the arad of people. This is what our aslaf, they saw their religion to be in. And this is something which is truly difficult to do. To withhold your tongue from harming people, it is something difficult. Why? Because we enjoy this as human beings. We enjoy speaking ill of people. We enjoy attacking people. Whenever we sit in our majalis, whenever we sit together as family, as friends, what do we end up doing? We end up speaking about other people. We end up attacking their honor, slandering them, wa iyadu billah. Why? Because this is something we find attractive, this is something we enjoy, we find ladha in this. And Sayyidina Abu Hurayra radiallahu ta'ala in the Sahih al-Bukhari rahmahullahu ta'ala, he says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, حُجِبَتِ النَّارُ بِالشَّهَوَاتِ وَحُجِبَتِ الْجَنَّةُ بِالْمَكَارِ. That the fire of Jahannam has been surrounded by shahawat, by desires, things that are easy to perform. The fire of Jahannam is covered and cloaked in these things. And the Jannah, paradise, it is cloaked and covered with things that are hard, difficult. Abstaining from harming people is something difficult, which Jannah is covered with. And it's something that we must endure, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal insan, innaka kadihun ila rabbika kadhan famulaqih. That, O human being, O person, O Abdullah, O Fatima, you will toil your way to your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will toil and work hard. You will labor against yourself until you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is so easy to fall into. Something which is extremely easy to fall into, attacking and harming, speaking ill of people. Even Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha wa allaha, طيبه طاهره, the wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam in Sahih al-Bukhari, when she said to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, "Ta hasbuka min safiyyata kada wa kada," ta'ni annaha qasira. When she said to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, that it is enough for you for Sayyida Safiyya radiallahu anha, such and such. Some of the narrators, they said such and such, she meant that she is short in her height radiallahu anha. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam turned to her and said to her, لَقَدْ قُلْتِ كَلِمَةً لَوْ مُزِجَتْ بِمَاءِ الْبَحْرِ لَمَزَجَتْهُ. O Sayyida Aisha, you have said such a statement. Something so easy to say. She is short. Her height is not the best of heights. Her height is undesirable. You have said such a statement. Were it to be mixed with the water of the ocean, it would pollute the whole ocean. Such is the gravity of our tongues, what we say from our tongues, what our tongues escape. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَتَحْسَبُونَهُ لَيِّنًا وَهُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَظِيمٌ. You see it, you perceive it to be something small, something minor, something insignificant. وَهُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَظِيمٌ. And with Allah al-Jalal, in His sight subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is something great, something severe, something which is magnified beyond which you can imagine. It is not something small to speak about the honor of the people, to speak about your brothers and your sisters. This tongue of ours, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَمَا مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَدِيمٌ. Never does a person say any single word, مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ. Any single word, never does a human being say any word except that there is an angel observant, ready and waiting to document that word that escaped his lips. This is the check the gravity of our tongues, which we are unaware of. And this tongue of ours, it has a connection to our heart. It has a strong and a deep connection between our hearts and between our tongues. As Sayyidina Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, as reported in the Musnad of Imam Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, Imam Ahmad rahmahullahu ta'ala, where he said that لا يستقيم إيمان عبد حتى يستقيم قلبه ولا يستقيم قلبه حتى يستقيم لسانه. That a person's iman, a person's faith, a person's belief, it will never be sufficient, it will never be straight, it will never be rectified until his heart is rectified. And a person's heart will never be rectified until his tongue is rectified. The connection between our tongues and our hearts. It's for that reason that Imam Yahya bin Mu'ad al-Razi rahmahullah ta'ala, he used to say that al-qulubu kal-quduri fi sudur taqri bima fiha wa magharifuha al-sinatuha, that the hearts, they are like containers in the chest, and what spills out of them comes out from the tongue. What is contained in our hearts, the excess spills out and leaks out and is evident from our tongues. If someone's speech, it is sweet, then know that his heart is the same. And if someone's speech is harsh, then know that his heart is the same, because there's a connection between our hearts and between our tongues. Our tongue, Sayyidina Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in the Jami' of Imam Tirmidhi rahmahullah ta'ala, he said that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا أَصْبَحَ ابْنُ آدَمَ فَإِنَّ الْأَعْضَاءَ كُلَّهَا تُكَفِّرُ اللِّسَانِ وَتَقُولُ اتَّقِ اللَّهَ فِينَا فَإِنَّمَا نَحْنُ بِكْ فَإِنْ إِسْتَقَمْتَ إِسْتَقَمْنَا وَإِنْ إِعْوَجَجْتَ إِعْوَجَجْنَا. That whenever any human being, he awakes in the morning, then all of his limbs, his hands, his feet, all of his limbs, they humble themselves, they humiliate themselves in front of the tongue. And they say, fear Allah dhul jalal, have taqwa of Allah dhul jalal regarding us, because we are a result of you. If you are straight, correct, and upright of tongue, then the rest of the body will be upright. And if you are crooked, then the rest of the limbs of the body, they will also be crooked. It's for this reason that Sayyidina Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he used to say, وَاللَّهِ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ غَيْرُهُ مَا عَلَىٰ ظَهْرِ الْأَرْضِ شَيْءٍ أَحْوَجَ إِلَىٰ طُولِ السِّجْنِ مِنَ اللِّسَانِ. That by Allah, there is nothing upon the face of this earth which is more in need of being imprisoned and jailed more than this tongue, because of the harm that this tongue causes. The harm that it causes our brothers and our sisters, our friends and our companions, are harmed because of this tongue which moves in our mouths. This tongue, Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says that one time in the Jami' of Imam Tirmidhi, the Sunan of Ibn Majah rahmahullah ta'ala, that one time with our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam on a journey, and I found time to ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a question when nobody was around. And I said, O Messenger of Allah, أخبرني بعمل يدخلني الجنة ويباعدني من النار. O Messenger of Allah, tell me of one deed that will gain me entrance into paradise and that will take me far from the fire of Jahannam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, O Mu'adh, لقد سألت عن عظيم. O Mu'adh, you have asked a severe, grave question. This is not something easy. One deed that can gain you entrance into paradise, and one deed that can save you from the fire of Jahannam. Then our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he began listening to Sayyidina Mu'adh radiallahu anhu, certain deeds, praying five prayers, giving in alms, fasting, making hajj, praying qiyam al-layl. And then in the end, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, أَلَا أُخْبِرُكَ بِمِلَاكِ ذَلِكَ كُلِّهِ أَوْ مُعَادٍ. Should I not tell you as to the base of all of those deeds? He
He said, of course, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took out his tongue and he said, Kuffa alayka hada. Restrain this tongue of yours. This tongue of yours can be the destruction of all of your good deeds. Restrain this tongue of yours. Sayyidina Mu'adh radiallahu anhu said, Ya Nabi Allah, wa inna lamu'akhadhuna bima natakallamu bihi, O Messenger of Allah. Will we be held accountable for our deeds to such an extent that it requires our tongues? He said, Thakilatka ummuka ya Mu'adh. وَهَلْ يَكُبُّ النَّاسَ عَلَىٰ وُجُوهِهِمْ فِي النَّارِ إِلَّا حَصَائِدُ أَلْسِنَتِهِمْ أَوْ نُعَانْ May your mother lose you. Will the people be thrown and cast into the fire of Jahannam because of anything except for the harvesting of their tongues? Except because of what their tongue harvested for them, they will be thrown into the fire of Jahannam. This tongue of ours, Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Sahih of Imam Muslim rahmahullah ta'ala, he said that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said to them once, أَتَدْرُونَ مَنِ الْمُفْلِسِ O my companions, are you aware who the person is who is bankrupt? And they said, الْمُفْلِسُ فِينَا مَنْ لَا تَرْهَمَ لَهُ وَلَا مَتَاعَ O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, in our vernacular, from what we understand, the bankrupt person, the muflis person is he who has no dirham to his name, neither does he have any goods with him. He doesn't have any commodity, not a single penny to his name. To us, this person is muflis. This person is bankrupt. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-muflisu fi ummati, ya'ti yawm al-qiyamati bi salatin wa siyamin wa zakah, wa ya'ti qad shatama hada wa qadafa hada wa akala mala hada wa safaka dama hada wa daraba hada. That the muflis in my ummah, he will come on Yawm al-Qiyamah with good deeds. He will come with Siyam, with Salah, with Zakah. And he will also come on Yawm al-Qiyamah having abused this person, having spoken ill of this person, having beaten this person, having stolen the wealth of this person, having spilt the blood of this person. And all these people will be surrounding him. All these claimants will be surrounding him. فَيُعْطَى هَذَا مِنْ حَسَنَاتِهِ وَهَذَا مِنْ حَسَنَاتِهِ And his good deeds, his salah, his siyam, his zakat, they will be given and distributed out to all these people who he wronged. فَإِنْ فَنِيَتْ حَسَنَاتُ قَبْلَ أَنْ يُقْضَى مَا عَلَيْهِ أُخِذَ مِنْ خَطَايَاهُمْ فَطُرِحَتْ عَلَيْهِ And if all of his good deeds, all of his siyam, all of his salah, all of his birrul walidain, all of his husnul khuluq, if all of his good deeds, if they all run out and are depleted by the end of it, and there are still people waiting for their rights to be given to them, their sins will be taken from them. فَطُرِحَتْ عَلَيْهِ And they will be cast upon him. ثُمَّ طُرِحَ فِي النَّارِ And then this person will be cast and thrown into the fire of Jahannam because of his tongue. He will come, having qadafa hada, spoken ill of this person, shatama hada, abusing this person because of his tongue. Is there for this reason that our Salaf alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Imam Abdul Rahman ibn Mahdi rahmahullah ta'ala, these are people who had fahm and basira and fiqh. He said, lawla anni akrah أن يعصى الله لتمنيت أن لا يبقى أحد إلا واغتابني That were enough for the fact that I hate that Allah Azza wa Jalla to be disobeyed in this world, I would have loved that nobody remained in this world except he backbited me. فأي شيء أهنأ للعبد من حسنة يجدها في صحيفته يوم القيامة لم يعلمها ولم يعمل بها For which What is there which will bring more comfort to a person than a good deed which he finds in his record on Yawm al-Qiyamah, which he doesn't even know about, which he didn't even perform? Those good deeds that because someone backbited him, their good deeds will be transferred into his record on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Were it not for the fact that I hate Allah to be disobeyed in this world, I would have wished everybody had backbited me. And Imam Abdullah bin al-Mubarak rahmahullah ta'ala, he said, لَوْ كُنْتُ مُغْتَابًا أَحَدًا لَغْتَبْتُ وَالِدَيَّ فَإِنَّهُمَا أَحَقُّ بِحَسَنَاتِي That were I to back by anybody, I would have backbited my parents because they are the people who are the most deserving of my good deeds. I don't wish for my good deeds to go to waste to anybody else. If my good deeds were to go to anybody, I would know that they go to my parents. So if I were to backbite anybody, I would backbite my parents. And this sin of ghibah, of backbiting, which we all know the definition of dhikruka akhaka bima yakrah, mentioning the bad points of your brother which he dislikes behind his back, backbiting, regarding which Allah bin Jalal compares it to, as we all know, eating carrion, eating dead meat. And yuhibbu ahadukum an ya'kula lahma akhihi maytan fakarihtum. Would any of you love for him to eat the dead meat of his brother? Rather you would abhor it. Allah bin Jalal makes similar the result of backbiting and eating the dead meat of your brother, of your blood brother, eating his dead meat. This is what backbiting is similar to. As Sayyidina Anas radiallahu ta'ala reports for us in the Sunnah of Imam Abu Dawud rahimahullah ta'ala, that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Lamma uwija bi, when I was ascended to the heavens on Laylatul Isra'i wal Mi'raj, marartu bi qawmin, I passed by a group of people, lahum adfaru min nuhas, they had nails made out of copper, forged for them from copper, wa yakhmishuna biha wujuhahum wa sudurahum, and with these nails of copper they would scratch and itch at their faces and their chests. And I said, man ha'ulai ya Jibreel, O Jibreel, who are these wretched individuals? He said, ha'ulai alladhina ya'kuluna luhum an-nas wa yaqa'una fi a'radihim. This is the end result of those people, who they would backbite people, they would eat the flesh of people, and they would attack their honor. May Allah bin Jalal allow us to control our tongues. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور. السماوات والأرض رتقا ثم فتق بقدرته ما رتق أقسم جل جلاله بالشفق والليل وما وسق والقمر إذا اتسق ثم أقسم لتركبن طبقا عن طبق ثم قال فما لهم لا يؤمنون. وأصلي وأسلم على من بعثه ربي جل جلاله بالحق وبالحق نطق روحي وأبي وأمي ونفسي وما أملك له فداء عليه الصلاة والسلام. ثم أما بعد, another disease of our tongues which we are unable to control is the sin of lying, of kadhib, of lying, of speaking ill truths, of speaking that, of relaying news which is untrue. Such a sin, I will relate to you one hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, of Sayyidina Samura bin Jundub radiallahu anhu, to try to draw a picture for you how grievous the sin is of lying. Sayyidina Samura bin Jundub radiallahu anhu, he said that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, after Salatul Fajr, normally he would ask us, anyone among you see any dream last night? And he said that last night, Atani al-laylata atiyan, two angels came to me last night in my dream. And they said to me, فَقَالَ لِي انطلق. They said to me, let us proceed, let us go, فَانْطَلَقْنَا. So we went. And the hadith is amazing and strange, ajeeb and ghareeb. If you have time, when you go home, read out this lengthy hadith of Sayyidina Samura bin Jundub radiallahu anhu. And he says, فأتينا على رجل مستلق على قفا. We came across a person who he was lying on his side. وإذا آخر قائم عليه بكلوب من حديد. And there was another person standing, towering over this person with a hook made of iron. وإذا هو يأتي أحد شقي وجهه. And this person, he would come to one half of this person's face. فَيُشَرْشِرُ شِدْقَهُ إِلَى قَفَاهُ. And he would insert this hook into the jawbone of this person and rip it to his side. وَمَنْ خِرَهُ إِلَى قَفَاهُ. And into his nostril and rip it to the side. وَعَيْنَهُ إِلَى قَفَاهُ. And insert this hook into his eye and rip it to his side. And when this is finished, he would move to the other side of this person's face and do the same thing. And before the left side is finished, the right side would reform. And this would continue happening. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam expressed ta'ajjub and said, Subhanallah, ma hadan. Oh, Subhanallah, glory be to Allah Jalla Jalal. Who are these people? And the two angels said to him, Intalik, intalik, fantalakana, proceed, proceed, go forward. And they went forward. Until the end of the hadith, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave the ta'bir of this dream, gave the interpretation of who this person is. He said that this person is the person who would yakhdu min baytihi. He would exit from his house in this morning. فَيَكْذِبُ الْكَذْبَةَ تَبْلُغُ الْآفَاقِ. And this person, he would lie such a lie that he would reach the horizons of the earth. This person, such is his humiliating, grievous, disgusting punishment in the barzakh, that his jaw, his nostril, his eyes would be ripped to the sides continually until Yawm al-Qiyamah, because he lied a lie that reached the ends of the earth, that reached the horizon. And today, we live in an age of social media, where by the click of a button, by the press of a button on the screen, by one retweet on Twitter, by one share of a post on Facebook, we can spread news like wildfire. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said in Sahih Muslim, the hadith of Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ كَذِبًا أَن يُحَدِّثَ بِكُلِّ مَا سَمِعَ. It is enough to render a man a liar that he narrates everything that he hears, anything that he reads, anything that he sees, he relates it to others, he retweets it, he reposts it on Facebook. Such is his punishment in Yawm al-Qiyamah if it is false. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us to do, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, in ja'akum fasiqun min naba'in fatabayyanu. Oh, you believe. If any person, rebellious person, comes to you with any news, fatabayyanu, check it up, verify this news before you pass it on to others. So may Allah Dhul Jalal allow us to control our tongues. May Allah Dhul Jalal allow us to only use our tongues for that which is beneficial, for that which will bring benefit to the people. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, Man kana yu'minu billahi wal yawmil akhir, falyakun khayran aw liyasmut. Whoever believes in Allah Dhul Jalal and the last day, let him say that which is good, or let him be silent. وَقُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّذِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ. And say to my slaves that they should say that which is the best, that which is ahsan, that which is the best thing to say. Not to waste their breath on false news, on ghibah, on namima, in lying. Rather, they should withhold their tongue and only say that which is the best. هذا ما عندي والله تعالى أعلى وأعلم بالصواب وعلمه أتم إن أريد إلا الإصلاح ما استطعت وما توفيقي إلا بالله عليه توكلت وإليه أنيب. عباد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رعاكم الله على من أمرتم بالصلاة والسلام عليه. يقول تباركت أسماؤه وجل ثناؤه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم زيننا بزينة الإيمان وجعلنا هداة مهتدين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان وجعلنا مع الراشدين. اللهم طهر قلوبنا من النفاق وأعمالنا من الرياء وألسنتنا من الكذب وأعيننا من الخيانة فإنك تعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين. اللهم اغفر لنا ولجميع موتانا وموتى المسلمين واشفنا واشف مرضنا ومرضى المسلمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.